is naturally, you know, eating stuff like that. And then, because I know one missionary to Korea, she ate dinner every time with us. And then every time I go there, you know, she has some stash, secret food that she likes. Peanut butter. I know where she's stashed. So I go there. I go there, I eat, and she got really, I saved for the rainy day, you know? And you took it, no? Likewise, let's get it, okay? Let's get it this way, okay? So in law, okay? It's personal. And I think it's first important stuff. That it's really supported by what? Psalm. And then not only in law, not only he says, okay, he went to heaven and he was sitting down, and then he says he gave us gifts to us. He gives gifts to me. Right? And then some people to be the apostle, some people to be evangelists, some people teachers and preachers, okay? Right? So what? Why God gives gifts? So that, what? Prepare God's people for works of service. So the gospel changes, we have to look at things different way. Basically, we go to school. Why go to school? Because we bet that when you go to school, we'll study hard and there's a payback, you know, because we can get a good job and live a comfortable life. But when we receive gospel of Jesus, our thinking changes. We are here not to serve us, me, but to serve others, right? So that Christ may build up. That means we are inviting people to come to know Jesus. So that we pray so that they can be established and rooted and finished up, so that they may have power to really understand how deep and how wide and long is the love of Christ. So I think that we are Christians are the ones who experience God's grace. And then Paul talks about later, he talks about his life testimony in 1 Timothy, he does it by favorite part. He talks about that in 1 Timothy, chapter 1, verse 12. I thank God, I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who has given me strength that he considered me faithful, appointed me to his service. Even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and a violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. The grace of our Lord Jesus was poured out on me abundantly, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. He just looked at his life and then, you know, he thanked God because he called me an apostle and then made me a faithful man of God, even though he was a blasphemer, persecutor, and a man. And here is what he would say that deserves full acceptance. Christ just came to the world to save sinners from whom I am the worst. But for that very reason, I was shown mercy so that in me, the worst of sinners, Christ Jesus might display his unlimited patience as an example for those who believe on him and receive from life. So I think that when you receive Jesus' love, we are changed. And then our focus is not us, but how we can serve others in love. And then we can build the community of God. And I know it's very challenging for us because when we are in stress, okay, that's the best time to know we are born again or not, okay? We are really stressed. You are really like, it's like whole world is crumbling, okay? You have incredible headache, you know, you're stressed out, blood pressure goes up, and up and down, you cannot sleep. And at that time, you take out this passage and think about that. Who do you consider about? You or the body of Christ? Others, so you can build up. And then, this is very challenging for us. And then this is a very good test for us. And then, this will really set you right, because then we can say, you know, I'm so weak, but when I look at Jesus, who came to us and who lived with us and also gave himself up, then in this struggle, please help me to prepare myself to be developed so that I can be mature and I can not only think about myself but others, but that the whole church can be built up. So I think that's a very important thing. And then he said, we have to be mature. We have to grow. And this is, we pray God, oh, this is a good opportunity to be mature. So he said, so that knowledge and they become mature, attaining the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Fullness of Christ. The fullness of Christ is important. The best example of Christ, the fullness of Christ is, essence is, the, is dying on the cross. And then resurrection. So when you are about to die, like Paul, he really prayed for the Ephesians to know love. Love is love. And then he says, I'm a prisoner of the Lord. Because I'm not just because I made a certain move and then I make a prisoner. No, this is an opportunity for me to pray for the Ephesians and build up his church so that, that we can be mature servants of God. So we can grow. Right? So we thank God. I know some people have hard time, okay? Right? And some people have hard time. And Jeremiah, he doesn't sleep, I don't know why. Right? He stays up all night and doing experiments. I know all kinds of problems. But through this, we really think about God's love shown through Jesus, and then we can be mature, and then we can see, I want to know Jesus, and his death and resurrection, and this is mature, okay? Okay, so this is the first in love, okay? Right? So I wish you guys be in love, okay? In love. Who are in love right now? Okay, Gideon is in love. Come on, everybody in love. We are in love with Jesus, okay? Right? I hope that by God's grace, Christian can be in love soon, okay? And Jeremiah also. Right? How about Stephen? You are in love? Okay, he's in love. Anyway, so I talk about the bearing one another in love, okay? Right? So bearing one another in love. And there's another in love coming up, okay? Instead, speaking the truth, truth in love. Truth in love, okay? Speaking the truth in love. There's another one, I think it's first one. 15? Yeah, 15. Okay. This is my experience, okay? I don't know how it is. Because, you know, I'm a correct guy. I'm a correct guy, okay? I'm very correct. Because I study hard. And then I can win the argument, okay, because we know correct data and everything, right? But I realized that doesn't really move anybody, okay? So correctness without love is useless, right? Because you can be so correct, and you can tell them, you have to do this, and you have to do this, and so correct, you know? And then, I don't know, should I use my mother's example? But I'm not sure what to do. She's correct, so correct. So correct, you know? And then I said, you are annoying me. You don't love me. Please love me. But I think, well, it's a good example. It's a bad example because she, my mother loves me, okay? But you know, some guy, you know, he just come to you and they don't care, you know, but they come to you and say a few things about you, you know? But that doesn't really move you, okay? But when somebody comes to you, deeply loves you and tells you, guess what? What you are doing is not right. I really care for you. Right? And please reconsider your ways. Please repent and come to Jesus. Right? Like that. Then you really think about, oh yeah, I might listen again. So I think that what Jesus did was that he spoke truth in love. Truth in love. He came down.